Hey guys, I came out to use my trusty old Harbor Freight battery charger and it started making a very loud buzzing sound. And this battery charger engine starter tried to become a fire starter and started smoking pretty bad. You can hear me clamoring around in the background trying to find the plug and get the thing unplugged, which I've already done at this point, but it's still smoking pretty good. And it'd be easy to think that I might have done something wrong, but nothing's hooked up incorrectly. All the settings are correct. The red clamp's positive. There's no reverse connection light. There's not even any indication on the gauge. It's not in starting mode, and it's only in the float charge. So something inside's gone sideways. We're going to have to go inside to see what's going on. But you can see the smoke's coming out of the back, so that's pretty clear where the source is. The nine commandments of charging on the back, I have obeyed all of them. And if you look inside, you can see that the diode rectifier assembly is the source of the problem. This is a spring-loaded diode housing, and there's a couple of button diodes that are held against that plate. Everything on the other side in here looks pretty good, but it's hard to say what else might have failed with this kind of a meltdown. But I'll try to give you a closer look of the rectifier assembly here. If we zoom in where the wires connect to the diode housing, you can see that was probably the primary source of the smoke. That, and of course, the insulation on the wires also melted. So that's why it continued to smoke even after it was unplugged. And the way these things work, you've got AC coming in one side. The AC voltage goes into the top windings, comes out the bottom, it's 12 volt, but it's still AC, has to go through the rectifier, which straightens it out, turns it into DC voltage. And on its way to your battery, it goes through a 20 amp safety breaker here. And obviously that didn't do us any good here because it did not shut itself off. If we want to take a closer look, you can see the contact surface for this button diode is pretty badly burned, so that's probably the cause of the issue, is a high resistance buildup. And you could buy button diodes, but the housing is ruined, so you'd have to buy the housing, which you buy as a kit. Old Schumacher battery chargers used to use a similar rectifier setup, but even if you replace it, you're going to have to replace all the burnt and melted wires as well, which is a pain. This unit gave me about 8 solid years of service, and since the cost of a new Cen-Tech battery charger at Harbor Freight is less than the cost to replace these diodes, I think it just makes sense to buy a new one. Well, if you enjoyed this video, I hope you'll give a thumbs up and share it with somebody else. Thanks for watching.